Everybody, it's Chris Eads, otherwise known online as Wootini, here with another weekly Gay Gamer video podcast. This week, I know, I warned you last week, we're talking all about the new Foundation update to No Man's Sky. Okay? And it's funny because I've seen online, like, people are like, oh, finally, like, this is the game that I would want to play. Or, now it's good. And I feel differently than that. Not that it's bad. The update is great. But what the update has done, and I'll explain, is it kind of turns it into more of a regular game. Which, clearly people are like, oh, this is what I wanted. I wanted a regular video game. So it's not nearly as unique as it was before the update. Basically, now, like, I noticed initially that, like, the planets looked a little different. They looked a little more dynamic and visually interesting because they, like, changed the algorithm or whatever. But I hadn't really been able to explore it because it literally updated, like, the day that I shot last week's episode. So now that I've had a week with it, it seems like they've made it slightly more, not difficult, but, like, time-consuming, maybe? Because elements are a lot less frequent now, it seems. Like, even plutonium is, like, not nearly as frequent on the planets I'm visiting. So, like, I'm really trying to find it and stockpile it and not jump around in my ship too much because I'll use it up. And zinc is, like, barely anywhere now, which is weird. But I decided that I would try to build a base, because that's one of the things you can do now, is build a base. And there was a planet that I really liked. It's very Earth-like, very pretty, and I couldn't find a place to build your base. You're supposed to find an abandoned base and, like, take it over, but I couldn't find one. And you can scan from space now, and which is really helpful. Like, from space, you can scan a planet, and it will tell you, like, if there's an abandoned base or whatever. It did that before, but it was a lot less frequent. Now it's much more like, okay, you can scan for it. Like, it's a more powerful scan now. And it also tells you what minerals, the major minerals that are on that planet, so that if you're looking for a specific mineral, you can know whether or not you should waste your time on that planet looking for it. I mean, obviously you should still visit the planet to, like, explore it and see the alien life, but, like, that's part of the problem, is, like, now it's more direct, so that I find myself not being as thorough with my exploration. Because I couldn't find anything on this planet, and I was like, fine. The only place where I could find to build, there was an abandoned base that I could take over on a planet that, I think the weather was okay, but it was, like, completely barren. I got a nice picture on that planet, but I wouldn't want to live there. You know, it's a nice place to visit. You don't want to live there. There's, like, no plants, no animals, and I'm just like, this isn't where I want to stay. So, eventually I did find another temperate, Earth-like planet with beautiful pink grass and blue skies and oceans and tons of animals everywhere. And I decided, nothing was showing up from a space scan, but I decided to build one of the little scanners, because now another thing that's different since the update is I feel like the landing sites with the buildings and such, they're a lot less frequent than they used to be. And when you do find one, there's no scanners anymore, because they've given you the ability to build at any time your own save points, your own scanners, your own everything. So I don't know how I feel about that. I much preferred, like, finding them. But I built a scanner, and I said, okay. And it was only the second one I built. The first one, I was looking for a monolith, but it didn't give me the option to look for a monolith, so I was like, okay, that's rude. But this one, it said habitable base. So I selected habitable base, and it's like, oh yeah, there's one right over there. So I said, okay, fine. So I went over there, and it was beautiful. It was perfect. It's right by some little hills, and there's an ocean, and there's animals everywhere, and I was like, this is great. So I took that as my base. slightly difficult because I tried to go inside and claim it, but I couldn't figure out how to do it and I had to go online. And it turns out that the reason I was like, I see this terminal, but I can't activate the terminal. What's going on? And I was like, oh my god, is this glitchy? Because I really want this base. And I went over to the terminal and I just held down square anyway, and it activated and said, okay, now this is your home base. And I was like, maybe I shouldn't have done that. If it's being glitchy, this isn't a good idea. But then what I realized was I still had photo mode on from taking the picture of my base from above. And when you turn on photo mode, it literally gets rid of every HUD icon and graphic and everything, and they stay gone. So it doesn't tell you anything, so you don't even get, that's why I didn't get the prompt to say, press square here to activate and claim as your home planet. Like, there were no prompts on anything, and I went, oops. So I turned that back on, and then everything was fine. I like photo mode because you can take prettier pictures without all the crap, but I do wish that it was easier to just toggle on and off. You have to go back into the menu every single time. You have to go into the options menu and be like, turn it off, turn on the photo mode. And then it's always like, you won't get any kind of warnings. And I'm like, that's fine. And I take my picture, and then I gotta remember to turn it back on again. So I started a base, and I've since expanded it by a few rooms, because you can only have one terminal in each room. So I have my construction terminal with my little Gek that I recruited, because when you go to the space stations now, there's a bunch of people hanging out, and you can just, one of them is like the person that's at the bay, at the space station, and the other ones are just hanging out, and some of them are looking for jobs. So there's a Gek, he's like, hey, I'll come work for you, it's fine. So he's researching how to build new things. So he's like, hey, I can help you build a science terminal. Then you can research sciencey things. But in order to do that, I had to get a specific kind of element, which was not available in my system. Thankfully, I did find it on a planet in the next system I jumped to. And then from the space stations now, you can teleport to your base. So that's super helpful. So I don't have to spend warp drive cores going back and forth. I don't have to keep building warp cells and like warping multiple times. I mean, that would help me get that achievement, but I'd rather like teleport. It's faster. It's a little weird that your ship teleports with you, but whatever. And so then I built my science terminal. Then I tried to build my armory terminal, but you couldn't put two terminals in one room, so now it's just this big empty room with just one little thing. So I had to build another one and put the armory in there and then get a Viking to work that. And so I'm slowly expanding my base. And thankfully the construction Gek, he showed me how to build like random stuff because they were these big empty rooms. And now I can build, like, little chairs and filing cabinets and displays and lights and that sort of thing. I got my decorative items now. There was one glitch where, like, I went into my base and suddenly, like, the hallway leading to the armory was, like, gone. And I had to, like, physically build a door to the hallway. Like, the hallway was still connected to the building, but it was, the building's wall was there. And I couldn't just... Although I didn't try to just walk through it, like if it was a graphical glitch, but I could still walk through it, but that would be weird. So I built a door. Whatever. It's the armory. I have a door just in case something blows up and nobody else gets hurt. I'm also making my base all pink. Pink and purple. Those are my colors. Because you can kind of change the colors of things. But what I realized in building my base is that it has now become a series of fetch quests, and I don't know how I feel about that, because it's like, like that's not the game I was enjoying. It's not a bad game, but it's not the relaxing, let's just explore the universe, and do whatever. So we'll see. I feel like at some point I'm gonna get a little bored with all the constant fetch quests. Like, there's certain things in there that, like, are helpful, like the hazmat gauntlets to access radioactive elements, or the advanced mining laser, since they suddenly decided that you can't just mine titanium now, you have to have an advanced mining laser to do that. That was weird. I'm like, since when? But now I have that, so it's fine. I can mine everything now, I think. But it's weird because it's like, it turns it into a regular game, and I'm just like, So I feel like I'm gonna stop doing the fetch quests after a little while and just get back to exploring the universe at my own speed and doing my own thing. And then maybe I'll, and then, because then I can be like, oh, well, all right, now I'm going to go back and check on my base and see what's going on there. Because I can always teleport back at any point. The only problem with that is that I wish that I had named that planet or system something specific. Because I haven't been renaming everything because it's just, it's too time consuming. I mean, like, there's a lot of things to name. But now that I have picked a home planet in a home system, I wish I could name those so that I could easily find them. I have to remember the gibberish name, which is annoying. But you can't rename things, which I get, because you can't rename something that somebody else has named if you discover it. That's not cool. But I feel like if you've just uploaded something and registered that as your discovery, you should be allowed to rename it at any point. I'm just saying. Or if you've claimed something as a home planet, that should give you the ability to rename it at that point. Oh well. If I find another planet that I would rather have a base on, I can move that base to this, like, I can just destroy that base and rebuild it on this planet. But if I find another planet where I want to build a base, I will make sure that I rename it later, you know? That way I can have a proper home that I've named. But oh, also, I landed on my first freighter. You can buy freighters. What happened was there was a distress call while I was heading for the space station, and I flew over and I fought off the fighters and saved the freighter, and they were like, you know, you're standing with the Viking has gone out and whatever. And then all of a sudden I got so close to the freighter that I just sort of automatically flew into the landing bay, and I was like, what the? And I got out of my ship and it was like, go see the captain for your reward. And I was like, okay. So it's big. So I kind of went up the stairs and down the hall and up some more stairs and then down another hall and then around. And then eventually I found the bridge. And then I went to talk to the captain and he was all like, hey, do you want to, you know, thanks a lot for helping us out. And you could either take a reward, refuse the reward, or make an offer on a ship. And I didn't know how much he was going to want for his ship, but I was like, I don't want to waste my money on a freighter right now. So I just took my reward, which was good. It was like 100K. Almost 100k units, so that was helpful. But it was fun. I hadn't been on a freighter yet, so I will plan on buying one in the future, but not yet. That's like the next step. I'm still working on my base. I'll get a freighter later, maybe. Like I said, I'm enjoying it, but it's interesting that, like, it's turned it into, like, a regular game. So I did actually take a break from No Man's Sky. I know, right? Because I've just been playing that, and I haven't been playing any other games, except for, obviously, Animal Crossing. But I did actually play something different. Not necessarily new. I put on Sleeping Dogs, the Definitive Edition, which is free with Xbox Live Gold right now in December. It's not new, though, because I remember, like, a few years ago, I had bought it on my 360, because it was like, you know, $4 or $5 or something, and I'd gotten an Xbox card for Christmas, so I had lots of money, and I was like, well, I'll just buy that then. But it was, like, really cheap, and I'd heard good things, so I was like, all right, let me try it. And so I played it for a little while, but not a long time, pardon me. So basically, the parts that I've played so far on my Xbox One, I've already played that part before. But, like, it's cool. It's an interesting game. I enjoy it. It's also interesting just to play something that's, like, you know, a properly structured video game as opposed to something freeform like No Man's Sky. I mean, I know Sleeping Dogs has kind of this open world thing that you can explore, but it has the missions and a storyline and, you know, characters. Oh, the characters. Oof. I forgot how much I enjoyed Sleeping Dogs because of, like, all the hot guys walking around in their tank tops with their big muscles and tattoos. It's very enjoyable. And the lead character is attractive and I was tempted to try playing the game in just my underwear, but I'm not that great at the hand-to-hand combat, so I kind of am still wearing the tank top with the baggy jeans because it gives me a 5% bonus to my hand-to-hand combat, so I could use that. But I just felt like I needed to play something other than No Man's Sky. Because there will be new games coming out that will eventually take me away from No Man's Sky. Like, for instance, I downloaded the demo for Parappa the Rapper, but I haven't played it yet. But they're remastering Parappa for the PS4. I'm not sure why you need it in 4K, but whatever. It's a great game, so it's fun, and I would like to play it again. The problem is that I'll try the demo, but I don't know if I want to buy it, because I'm afraid that because they're remastering it, they're going to charge like $15 or $20 for it, which would be insane. I'm thinking 15. 20 would be a bit much, like 10 to 15. Probably 15. But it's hard for me to justify spending $15 on a game that I literally have. Like, I have a physical copy of the PS1 disc, which I can actually play in my PS3, so if I want to play Parappa, I can. So I don't know if it's worth paying like $15 or whatever it's going to be just to play it on my PS4. But there are other games like Horizon Zero Dawn, Ni No Kuni 2. Oh my god, I'm so looking forward to that. And then of course there's the new Mass Effect Andromeda, which has an actual sort of date. I think they said spring, so that's coming probably the soonest. But interestingly, the new Mass Effect Andromeda trailer had me kind of underwhelmed. Because for me, the appeal of Mass Effect and like any BioWare game is going to be the storyline and the characters that you interact with or are in your party. Like the characters, the relationships, and the storyline, that's the appeal. And the various missions and side missions are like just the busy work and fun. But this trailer basically focused on the action and the missions and what you're going to be doing and how, you know, you're going to have to like build everything and craft everything and steal things and like you can't just buy things. And I'm like, okay, why are you trying to make it sound annoying? You know, I'm just like, that doesn't sound like fun. It might still be. It probably still will be. But it's also funny because it kind of sounds like the action adventure version of No Man's Sky, where every planet has a different hazard, whether it's environmental or alien creatures or whatever, and you're going to travel from planet to planet to planet, looking for some place for humanity to settle, I guess. And as you travel from planet to planet to planet, you have all these adventures. Of course, it's not randomly generated. They'll have very specific, like, here is this mission, and here is this base, and here is this kind of alien on this particular planet, you know. So it's going to be all very specific, and it can be much more exciting than something like No Man's Sky, which is all random. But like, people are already like, "Oh, Mass Effect Andromeda, it's what No Man's Sky was supposed to be." And I'm like, no! I really hate the No Man's Sky hate. Because No Man's Sky is what they said it was going to be. But yeah, anyway, so I think this one's gone on way too long, and I have games to play and things to do. And oh, right. Before I sign off this week, I realized that this is episode 299, so next week is my 300th video, which is insane to think that I've done 300 of these and anyone is still watching. The audience isn't as big as when it was on GayGamer.net, and it was on the RSS feed, and it got like a lot of play, and I would get like, you know, 100 or 200 views. Now I'm getting like 30 to 40 views, maybe 50 on a good day. But it's still amazing to me that even 30 or 40 people want to sit and watch me talk about video games for 10 to 15 minutes every week. Thanks. So, I realized I should do something special for my 300th episode, and I don't know what to do. So I thought I would do a Q&A, which I think I did for like my 100th episode, and answer your questions. So if you have anything that you want to know about me or whatever and gaming, like, ask away. And you can put them in the comments, or you can tweet them to me at WootiniGG. Just make sure that you specify that it's, you know, for a podcast, because otherwise I'll just answer you on Twitter, because that's what I would do. So I'll try doing that if I can get enough questions. If I only get a couple of questions, that's not really going to be enough. So I'll think of something else to do, and then I'll just answer the questions at another time. So please talk to me, and I'll see you back here next time, and we'll do something special. I don't know what yet. We'll see. Come back next week and find out. Bye!